Hello friends, in this video we will see another type of simple machine. The name of the machine is differential axle and wheel. Now differential axle and wheel, it is just a modification of simple axle and wheel. In simple axle and wheel we were having only one axle of only one diameter. Here in case of differential axle and wheel, it is called differential because we have two different axles having two different diameters. One is having the bigger diameter called as the bigger axle. Other is called as the smaller axle because it has a smaller diameter. Now on both the axles, that is bigger and smaller axle, string is wound or the rope is wound to which we are attaching the load with the help of this snatch block. At snatch block, it is like a hook which connects the load to be lifted. These two axles, they are connected to a shaft which is supported in bearings. These ends, they are called as bearings. On the other side of the axle, we are having effort wheel, which is a bigger wheel as compared to both the axles. And on this effort wheel, we are attaching an effort which we apply. This is the input quantity and here is the output quantity. Next, onto effort wheel, we are having again having the shaft which is supported in the bearings. Capital D is the diameter of effort wheel. Small d1 is the diameter of bigger axle. Small d2 is the diameter of smaller axle. So this was regarding the construction part. Now how it functions, how it works. When we apply effort, because this machine will function only if we apply the effort, that is effort is the input here. When we are applying the effort, that is either we would be pulling the string at the effort wheel or we will attach some weight here. So this effort wheel will rotate. That is here what will happen, this string when it goes down, the string would be unwound from this effort wheel. Now when the string is unwound from the effort wheel, the shaft rotates, diameter D1, this bigger axle will rotate, and what happens is that the string gets unwound from the smaller axle and it gets wound onto the bigger axle. So as we can see, this arrow is pointing downwards. It means the string is getting unwound, it is unwound from smaller axle and gets wound, and once it is wound onto the bigger axle, the load will move up. So by applying very small effort, we are lifting a huge amount of load. This will be the output for us. So this is the explanation of differential axle and wheel. Here we can calculate velocity ratio by using the formula 2D upon D1 minus D2, where capital D is the diameter of effort wheel, D1 is the diameter of bigger axle and D2 is the diameter of smaller axle. So in this video, we have seen construction, working and velocity ratio formula for differential axle and wheel.